becomes more dynamic and for real-time decisions, which is usually the case in airport. Do we reject an AI solution if we cannot understand it? In doing so, we would be ruling out a host of potential strategies which may be out of box, but which can give a huge required edge. The risk is that we may get outmaneuvered by an adversary who trusts AI and its offbeat workable outputs, and we must be mindful of this as combat commanders, as technologists, as we evolve ourselves to handle AI in future. To optimally use AI, we must first decide as to when the systems should be supervised by humans and when not. This is a decision that should involve technical logic and questioning. Humans are designed to be more effective at problem solving, whereas AI thrives in environments with high correlations and underlying patterns. Probably the most important consideration in this domain are the ethical ones. Can we ever get to a stage where we clear AI to take a human life? Taking it one step lower in terms of air war, would you implicitly trust a purely AI-based identification of foe? Suppose you haven't got an IFF response. Even if the human is taking a decision to shoot. I leave that for you to consider, and I have no doubt that these are the issues which will form topics of discussion during the symposium. To share with you, regarding IF, we have already embarked on the AI journey and having gone through some very important automation projects in the recent past, we have started testing AI and AI-based applications on some projects which are at different stages. We have already improved our operational efficacy by shrinking timelines in entire ELINT SIGINT analysis chain and thereby leading up to PFM generation for the required scenario in the area of operations. Image interpretation enmeshed with ELINT data is already being worked upon, and these are the areas that I am considering, what areas that the Air Force is already working. In the area of aircraft maintenance, which we have substantially digitized, we have all our fleets onto electronic maintenance management systems. Also, similarly, our entire inventory management has become computerized and digitized. So we have already started to work on an AI-based formulation as to come out with predictive maintenance or predictive threat scenarios or red flags. And this is again a project of importance. And all this that I'm talking about has been done in-house with the private industry. And none of them is kind of a project from foreign OEMs, mainly because of the sensitivity of some of these projects.